Okay, a few minutes just to walk through the course syllabus and take a glance at the course Blackboard page, which will be your anchor for kind of all information and assignments throughout our time together. So here I have up on the screen, I have our syllabus, which you can find on the course Blackboard site. And at the top, you can see my name, my email address. That is going to be the primary way to get hold of me throughout the semester. I am expecting that you will be using your GRCC email account. So when I send you an email through Blackboard, that's where it will be sent. So make sure you do that. I'm not going to have, just because of the times we're in, regular office hours this semester. But if you're able to, if you want to come in and talk face to face, I would actually love that. Just let me know and we can arrange something by appointment. I don't want to. I have a course kind of overview, small lecture, video lecture. So I don't want to, to duplicate a lot of stuff. And so I'm going to go through just the syllabus very, very briefly, but our course is going to be talking about living religions for the most part, with some detours around the world. We're looking at the major world religions across the globe today, from many, many perspectives. There are two required course texts for this class, both by Mary Pat Fisher, Living Religions. I have ninth edition here. I think there's a 10th edition out. It doesn't really make a huge difference, I think, whether you get the latest version of the text. I'm always in favor of students saving money, but I would say once you get down into the 8th and 7th edition, it becomes a markedly different text. So get the 9th or the 10th, and then with that, a companion piece, an anthology, which gives kind of specific readings from sacred texts and otherwise having to do with the various religions covered in the chapters in this book. So get these books as soon as you can. You can get them to the GRCC bookstore, of course Amazon. Look around and get the best deal that you can. Will be any other readings I ask you to do will be either Word documents or PDFs, and I will post them right in our weekly assignment folders on the Blackboard site. Grading breakdown. At the end of the day, the course is worth 1,000 points total, possible points, and I think there'll probably be some opportunities for extra credit along the way as well. Broken down into these equal chunks here. So your attendance and participation, which in an online class will be governed by or be decided by if you get your stuff in on time, if you complete your quizzes and assignments on time, and also your participation in discussion forums, which I'll talk about a little bit later. You'll have reading quizzes most every week. These will be timed reading quizzes on assigned readings from the textbook and otherwise. There'll be two formal tests, a midterm and a final exam, and those will be take-home essay assignments. There will not be short answer or objective questions on that, but I'll give you a choice of some long-form essay questions, which you will again write and upload to the Blackboard site by a given deadline. And there'll be one formal essay, a formal paper for the class, which I'm not going to say a lot about now, just for the sake of not overwhelming you with things. And we can get into that later as the course progresses. Just a note about my grading scale. I grade on a very straight scale, which I think might be different than if you've had classes at CC before, might be slightly different. So in my grading scale, 95 to 100 is a straight A, 90 to 94 is an A minus. I've heard from other students that in many of the classes, a 93 200 is a straight A. My grading scale is a little stricter. I don't think you'll find that I'm a particular kind of harsh grader, but I do think that a straight A has to reflect kind of a cut above, has to reflect excellent work across the board. So 95 to 100, and so on and so forth down the line throughout the letter grades. Yes, like I said, your attendance score will be based on the quality and regularity of your responses to discussion questions, your submission of assignments on time, and the like. Reading quizzes. Okay, so the way this works, again, all of this, of course, will be on the course Blackboard site. Each week, you'll have an online quiz, maybe one or two quizzes on the readings for that week, and these will be timed. And so, as you'll see on the course Blackboard site, what I'm asking you to do is to complete all the work for that week by 11:59 p.m. on the Sunday before the next week kicks in. So, at 11:59 on the Sunday at the end of one given week, the folder for the next week will open. And so I'll give you some grace in the early weeks because we're all kind of getting used to this new thing. But as we go on, I'll expect that you complete the quizzes by the end of the week for which those quizzes are assigned and due. So they're timed, and so usually the quizzes are around, somewhere between 10 and 20, 10 and 20 questions or so. And I'll give you, 15 to 20 minutes for those 10 questions, which I think you'll find is plenty of time. But I have the quizzes timed just so that you're not just you're encouraged to do the readings, and you're not just flipping through the book searching for answers rather than digging into the material. So you'll take those quizzes. You can attempt these quizzes twice, but the software will average your two attempts, and that will give you your final grade. And of course, the software will show you how well you do after your attempt. So obviously, if you ace it the first time out, there's no need for a second attempt. Let me know if you have glitches with those things. I mean, this is software, this is technology, things happen, and I can always reset a quiz for you if you need it. The midterm and final exam, like I said, will be feature a choice of take-home essays, and so I'll ask you to write on two out of three or three out of four. You will type these up as Word documents, and you will upload them to the Class Blackboard site. We'll spend as we kind of get up to these things in our course schedule. I'll give a heads up. I'll do a kind of a short, video review of how you might best approach these kinds of things. So more details on that to come. The course paper, like I said, I don't want to even talk about it now. We'll deal with it later. But there is one formal paper for the class, and I will upload that as an assignment once we're about kind of maybe midway through the class. Communication, if you need to get in contact with me, the best way to do it is my GRCC email account, just because the way things are, and especially my department is we're having our offices redone and revamped and moved, so my office phone won't even be an option for getting in touch with me, and I'm going to be here on irregularly anyway. All right, here's just a glance at the course schedule. Like, I don't want to go through all this in detail at this point, but I've arranged it by weeks on the course Blackboard site. You'll see that each week has its own folder, and in that folder is everything that I want you to do for that week. Readings to read, video lectures to view, and quizzes to complete, and if there's a discussion to do to add an answer to that. We'll take a look at the Blackboard site in just a second. But here on the syllabus, you can see each week the kind of the general topic for that week and the specific readings that you'll have for that week. And almost without exception, there'll be quizzes on each of those readings. But week 9, we'll get to the midterm. We'll just have 1 week dedicated for you to complete the take-home essay. And that gets us into the second half of the course down here. We'll be watching two films during the class, which again, I'll have discussion questions, and you'll upload your answers to them. The first film we'll watch is The Life of Pi, which is a film based on a very popular book, and it's a film that's filled with religious and spiritual ideas, largely rooted in the Eastern religions. There's lots of Hindu ideas, Buddhist ideas, but also later kind of monotheistic Christian Islamic ideas in that film as well. I hope you find it very, very interesting and fun to talk about. And then in the second half of the course, we'll watch Martin Scorsese's Silence, which is a powerful kind of gut-wrenching film about Jesuit missionaries going to Japan in the 1600s. And so I'll hopefully have an interesting online discussion about that as well. Right down here, you have the college policies and all the stuff, code of conduct, Title IX. That's all there for your own information, various numbers for emergencies and such. You can have a look at that on your own. All right, let's take a quick look at the course Blackboard site. So when you actually when you visit the site right now, there's a welcome page here, which kind of gives just a brief overview of what we're talking about. The most important link in the course will be this weekly assignments week. So if you click on that, you'll get to the orientation folder is where actually you'll find this video, and also a welcome video from me, telling me a little bit about myself and again more about the course. And then you'll see the folder for week one. And so let me just open this, have a look at it. So in each folder, I'll have kind of a graphic and then a short piece telling you exactly what is due for that week. So this week, I'm asking you to watch a few video lectures, course overview, talking about defining ancient religion. One of the first things we'll be looking at is actually ancient Greek theology, some mythology, some defunct dead religions, you might call, before we dive into our living ones. A reading an ancient Greek myth, Hesiod's Theogony in Works and Days, and then a quiz that you'll take on that. So we'll hit the ground running. So I'll expect that you can kind of take care of this, watch these things, read this document. You'll see that there's no reading from the course texts for this week, so that gives you some time if you need them to acquire those texts. But I will expect that you do this and then complete the quiz by the end of the week. Over on the left here, this kind of section will probably evolve as we go along, as we add things. Your discussion forums, if we're discussing a film or if I'm asking you to kind of respond to a reading, those will kind of pop up maybe every other week as part of your participation grade throughout. And that, again, any link to that will be in the weekly assignment folders. There'll be nothing that I ask you to do for the class that will be outside of this link, all right? But you can find specific information and a duplication of these things in links over here. Instructor, you can find, again, my information, same information that's on the syllabus. Various tools and research resources, these will become important for the paper as we get down to it, and a link if you can always find a copy of the syllabus here. All right, let me know if you have questions, and we'll see how this goes. I'm eager to kind of meet you virtually and hopefully in person at some point down the line. See you soon.